Transcribing PowerPoint in real time. Why transcribe? The ADA mandates content be accessible. Generally, this means a transcript must be provided for any video or audio content used in an online course. Transcription also adds value for non-disabled students because it is a complete set of notes for their lecture. Scripting video or audio can prevent the presenter from becoming sidetracked or rambling. Choosing text over video. Some instructors feel transcription causes them to have to do extra work. Because of this, some choose not to use video or audio in their lectures. Real-time transcription fixes this problem and provides the instructor with a very accurate copy of what was spoken as soon as they are done recording the audio or video components. Tools needed: a microphone, a webcam, or a capture device. PowerPoint with mix installed. VoiceNote, audio to text software. Word, which is your standard Microsoft Office application. And then you're going to need a YouTube account. The recording process. First, we're going to open our PowerPoint presentation. Then we're going to open VoiceNote. Probably we're going to need to do that on a second monitor because once we start mix, it will take over the entire screen area on the first monitor. Then we're going to start our recording in VoiceNote by clicking on the microphone icon. Once it's red, it is recording. And then we'll start slide recordings and mix in PowerPoint. Basically, when you have mix installed, you will see a tab that says mix on it. When you click that, then you're able to do slide recordings. During recording, keep an eye on VoiceNote. It has about a 2,000 character limit. Once you have about 3/4 of a page, you should start a new VoiceNote or cut the text and paste it into Word to clear the VoiceNote. Be sure to save your VoiceNotes as you are making them. Click the disk icon at the bottom of VoiceNote. Mix captures audio and video on a slide-by-slide basis. If you need to manage VoiceNote, or if you make a mistake, click the stop icon in Mix. Once everything has been adjusted, continue to make the recording. After recording, text preparation. Save your Mix / PowerPoint. Open a text editor like Word. Click the Customize and Control button in VoiceNote. This is going to bring up a list of the notes that you've saved. Open the first note you made for this recording, copy the text, and paste it into Word. Do the same process for any other pages of VoiceNotes you have. Keep in mind that if you were copying and cutting and pasting into Word as you were building your mix, you don't need to do this part of the process because your Word file is probably already complete. However, once your text file is complete, add any desired punctuation and make any needed corrections. Save the Word file. So, VoiceNote is very, very accurate, but it will make mistakes from time to time, or it will choose to interpret something like homophones, for instance. It could choose one or the other word, and in that case, you're going to want to go through and look at it to make sure that it makes sense. After recording, video preparation. Close mix, click export to video, choose a size. So on the bar on the side here, choose a size. We want the biggest one available, and then we want to save the file. Now here come the instructions for YouTube. So this is where it gets a little bit more tricky, but it's still a very straightforward process. You will need a YouTube account. You should have one specifically for your instructional videos. Do not use your personal YouTube account. Once you are logged in, click the upload button. It's right up in the upper right-hand corner next to your user account. Upload your video. Once it is finished uploading and converting, click on your YouTube account icon and click Creator Studio. click the video you want to add subtitles to. Click the CC or Closed Caption button. Set the video language if prompted. Typically, it's going to be English. Click Add Subtitles or New CC button. Once again, select the language. Click Transcribe and Auto Sync. Copy all of the text from the Word document you made. Paste the text into the transcription box in YouTube. Click Set Timings. After a while, YouTube can take several minutes to set the timings depending on the length of the video. Click on the English button under My Drafts. Check the timings for accuracy if desired. It does do a really good job of deciding, especially when it has verbatim text for what's being said. It does an excellent job of deciding where they should go. Click the Publish button. Now we need to get rid of the auto-generated subtitles. So click on English, and in parentheses it says automatic. Click Actions, and then click Unpublish. Click Exit, and your transcribed video is now finished. That has been Transcribing PowerPoint. Thank you for watching.